A very good morning to all. Today we have with us Dr. Mahesh Marda, who is the chairman and MD of the Premier Hospital, Hyderabad. Doctor is a consultant physician and has a 35 years of experience. So I would like to ask you one question. Kindly elaborate on the prophylaxis of statin and aspirin therapy in patients with dyslipidemia and heart attack.
India has a large burden of cardiovascular diseases and CVA, and statins and aspirin go a long way in the prevention of these attacks, heart attacks and strokes. Statins are like silver bullets. They have not only the action of reducing the cholesterol, but they also have other actions which are beneficial for weight reduction and other conditions. Statins, if used judiciously, are very helpful in the prevention of strokes and cardiovascular MIs. If they are used in the dosages of 5 milligrams to 40 milligrams as far as rosuvastatin, or up to 80 milligrams if atorvastatin is used, they can be used as a maintenance dose of 5 to 10 milligrams in certain group of patients who are highly under the risk for these complications, like those who have already had an attack of MI, or those who have had a very strong family history of diabetes and CVA. Aspirin is a double-edged weapon. There is some controversy about preventive aspect of aspirin. Aspirin should not be used for all the people who above the age of 40, just for the prevention of myocardial infarction. Aspirin is used judiciously in patients who do not have the tendency for GI bleed and other conditions, and it is helpful in patients, those who have only had a MI before, and for prevention. Aspirin has its own side effects, and it should be used judiciously. A dose of 75 to 100 milligrams is used in elderly people, and only thing which should be taken care of is it has bleeding tendencies, and it should be very carefully used. Aspirin can be stopped at the age of 75 in elderly, because there is not much of use after 75 years. And statins can be stopped when the LDL level goes below 80 milligrams, and it can be restarted once. But screening is very important in people who are highly susceptible to CAD and strokes.
Thank you, sir. Apart from this, what are the precautions the patient should take, and you can enlighten us with the lifestyle modifications?
We should realize that prevention is better than cure. So always it is always better to prevent a disease by our lifestyle modifications and diet. Diet is the most important culprit for all the diseases, and weight reduction goes a long way in the cure of many diseases, in the prevention of many diseases like cardiac and CVA. Obesity related osteoarthritis and other things also can be prevented by diet. And exercise is, in my opinion, 50% of all the treatments which we give. One side it is a diet and exercise, and other side it is the medication. By nature, human beings are mobile, and we should never have a sedentary habit, and we should be very careful while taking our food.
Thank you, sir, for enlightening us on the role of statins in the appropriate management of heart failure. And along with it, also thank you for enlightening us with the pharmacological approach and the lifestyle modification. Thank you, sir.